What's up, guys? This is BCFlem123 here. Hopefully you've got all the sound systems and crud worked out this time. But basically what we're going to be doing today is Chapter 2 of Knights of the Eternal Throne. Which I do not remember the title, but I know it'll come up. But basically, last time, Cassina saved us. We went for the Shadow Sets, right? I couldn't remember the title. Basically, I'm returning to the Drummond Cots after so many years. This time will look much different. Alright. And we've got our rewards from the first time. Now I've got a way better reward than what these stories. I've got a way better Seder staff than what these stories are providing. It's a volatile derelict saber staff. I bought it on the Galactic Tree. So yeah, if you guys are looking for good weapons or good armor, Galactic Tree Network is a good place to look. But you should just take these things anyway, just because, well, number one, you don't have a choice. Number two. Well, number two then. Basically. You can sell them for money, and I love getting credits. And I've got pretty much everything in from Tier 1 so far, anyway. Yeah, I've got a way better thing than that. I think I have that in my inventory, too. Basically, you can... Basically, when you get the command perks, you can either disintegrate items, which gives you command XP back, or you can choose to collect these items. I always collect the command tokens and whatever companion gifts I have. So, go ahead and claim those. Since it's a lot of an eco, the collected history of the true Sith is a massive influence gain for her. For her.
I'm touched.
Alright, I think we're pretty much ready to go. Nope, okay, I didn't think so. No influence gain. Alright. On with Chapter 2. Let's go visit Empress Asina. Last time I saw her, she was Darth Asina. So this should be like a
complaint to the Empress.
For some reason, this feels like a spin-off of what Darth Malkus wanted. How dare they not bow to me? I am the Alliance Commander. I am practically seen as equal. What'd you type in there, buddy? As you guys can see, it's a long walk to go see Asina. But basically, oh look, I have more new mail. Wait, what? Oh, right, never mind. It's been some time since I played this. Oh. Hello, Valkorion. How are you today?
Drummond Cars. I clung to this world for too long. Before I cast it aside as a failed experiment.
The Empire was stronger without you.
Were you?
Yes, sir.
This is the empty husk I left behind. But the Sith could still be a useful tool to help you seize the Eternal Throne.
Yeah,
Honored guests, welcome to Dromund Kass.
Moff Lorman.
It's Minister Lorman now.
Really? I figured your career was over after you lost the Ascendant Spear.
This story sounds too good to pass up.
Back in my SIS days, I may have blown up a prototype Sith warship. Lorman was the deputy commander.
It's Minister Lorman, and the past is irrelevant. I serve Empress Asena now. She awaits us in the throne room.
Welcome, Commander. These are strange times. Once we would have been on the same side. Now we negotiate as strangers.
I didn't expect to be on Dromund Kass again.
I can imagine. Much has changed for the better since you were last here.
I urge you not to be so critical, Empress. The Sith Empire has always been glorious.
I would like to continue this conversation on my personal shuttle. Just the two of us, speaking freely.
It may not be wise to split up.
Be ready if anything happens, and keep an eye on Lorman.
It's Minister Lorman! Minister Lorman! Is that so hard to remember?
Don't worry about us, Commander.
Oh my gosh. Lorman's outburst. Oh my gosh. I remember how hard I laughed the first time I heard it. Alright. Of course, they kneel before her, not me.
Athena's trying to throw in with the Alliance.
Better than bowing down to the Eternal Empire, right?
Oh, yeah. I remember when everyone used to bow down to us.
Make a hard right turn.
Sith who do not approve of the Alliance I offer. They hold tight to the old ways. But to stop Valin, we must work together.
So last time with my Jedi Knight character, I tried flirting with her, and it just... it was a total flop. She's not really even that attractive, honestly.
Taking her down is all that matters. I welcome any help I can get.
This does not end with Valin. We both know there is only one path to victory. You want to seize the Eternal Throne, and I will help you.
Why me? You don't want the throne for yourself.
I am focused on the survival of my people. Unchecked, Valin will grind us into dust. I am not powerful enough to stop her. You are. With my help. Engine's non-responsive. We need to bring it down. We're coming in too fast. Bail out!
No.
Skills are impressive, Commander. It's good to know your reputation is not exaggerated.
You handle yourself well in a fight.
I can pilot a shuttle, too, unless someone sabotages it. Probably the same person jamming our comm signals.
Lawman's behind this. I knew it.
Lawman lacks both the courage and competence to orchestrate a direct attempt on my life. My shuttle has an emergency beacon. The signal should cut through any interference. If help is coming, that's where they'll be.
Just about into the main network.
Someone's coming.
Forgive the intrusion, but I come bearing tragic news. The Empress's shuttle has crashed.
Crashed? Where?
Somewhere in the jungle. Unfortunately, the emergency locator is not transmitting.
That's impossible.
Not if the shuttle disintegrated. I'm afraid there's only one logical conclusion. The Empress and Commander are dead.
You're such a... Oh, you're dead. It's so dead. Looks good in my driving sticks, which you can get from the command. Hey, look, it's HK51. I'm just kidding.
Slogging through the forest to hunt you down was gonna be the worst part of this job. It's so much easier when the targets come to us. You must know who we are. Do you really think you can beat us?
The Geno Haridan fear no one. Not even you.
The Geno Haridan? I thought you were just a myth.
That's because we never leave witnesses.
The hunt begins!
Beacon destroyed, comm signal still jammed, and a fierce storm coming our way.
We haven't destroyed the last of our enemies.
I assume the Geno Haridan have a camp nearby. That should be our destination. It's likely the camp is heavily guarded.
It won't be once we're done.
Thank you.
Looks like the storm's not letting up anytime soon. I say we grab a shuttle and head out now.
The interference will disable comms and scanners. Not to mention the risk of an electrical surge frying our circuits.
Sean, I just heard the news. Let me express my sincere condolences.
SIS reporting has gone downhill since I left. The commander is missing, not dead.
Don't let foolish hope blind you. You are leaderless, as are the Sith. Someone must step in to fill the void.
Forgive me, but aren't you the former Republic Chancellor? You've already served your term.
True leaders don't need titles to hold power. I want what your leader wanted, to defeat Valen. Join me, and we can finish what he started.
Pass. I've had more than my fill of working with you.
You're still grieving. Eventually, you'll realize I'm right.
Yeah, right.
Storm be damned. The time for patience is past. Let's find the commander.
Cannot decide which is stranger, that the Geno Haradon are real or that they're hunting us.
We should be flattered. The Geno Haradon only accept contracts worthy of their skills.
This is one compliment I could do without.
Yeah, true enough. But anyway, other stealth detectors.
Bow before me!
Oh, Oh, I'm so excited. What is this? This is the right way to go. Where I was going before. Basically, this is kind of a boring chapter because you're basically just running around trying to get back to your companions to tell them, hey, I'm not dead. Oh, and this guy's a traitor. Yeah, so. You just kinda gotta bear with it a bit. It really is. Favorite chapter. My favorite chapter still to come, honestly. What's up, guys? And we are back. I realized the first couple times around I've been watching the videos that I've been recording, and I realized that I haven't really made these very interesting for you guys. And I think part of the reason is just because I played this story before. So, I mean, I might not make it seem very interesting, and for that I apologize. But on the other hand, I'd love to keep doing this, especially when new content comes out, because then it's more like a reaction video. We'll play it. Oh, the scene has disappeared. Okay. Taken care of now. So now what? Eh, kinda dark. Alright, so anyway, guys, we are gonna go ahead back to rolling on. Yeah, I will not lie, but this is a really boring chapter, so that's one reason I haven't really been able to keep things entertaining with the conversation and whatnot, stuff like that. Oh, no. That was dumb. Oh my gosh, that is really stupid of me to do. Oh my gosh, I cannot believe I just did that. Oh look, we're right there. Okay. I'm okay with that. Yeah, great. Droidy droids. Guys, off we go again. This time for realsies. Did I really just say... Oh my gosh. Just why did I just say that? Anyway, moving right along. We're going to go ahead now and investigate the equipment in the Geo-Herodin camp. For those of you who are wondering who the heck or what the heck is going on here, these Geo-Herodin guys are mercenaries.
I fear the storm is getting worse.
Good. It'll cover our approach to the Geo-Herodin camp.
I see why the Alliance follows you. Where others see problems, you see opportunity.
Very true. Not to mention I'm a really, really, really awesome Sith Lord. Yeah, did it to do. Let's see, we're just gonna cut you down the side. You down south. You didn't die for some reason.
Feel my wrath.
Which came to you is better than your defense. Thank you once again, Messina.
Found bodies at the crash site.
Messina, the Alliance Commander.
No, our people.
That means the targets are still out there. Find them!
Interesting. See, I don't know why these guys are hunting us, which is the key thing that we need to figure out. Just give me 1 second, my microphone keeps slipping. There we go. Alright. Should be able to hear me loud and clear now, guys. I'm going to do my best to make this a little more entertaining than I have been before. Because all this is probably one of those.
Found out why Greg's squad didn't check in. Lightning strike.
Survivors?
None. All of them fried to a crisp.
Salvage whatever gear you can, and keep moving.
Anyway, I'm gonna do my best to keep this semi-entertaining. Simply because I know it's difficult. to keep this attention. Here's a supply locker. I don't recall. I don't recall finding these before, actually. My Jedi Knight character. Here I possess the site. Okay. Maybe I did already find this. Alright. So we need to locate one more supply yet, then we can go ahead and move right along. Dang! These guys make some pretty big kills. I mean, look at this. Oh, wait. We missed a couple guys. I'm gonna have fun with this. Phantom strike. That did not work. Well, that worked.
Status report. Any sign of the targets?
No visual contact yet. Hard to track them through the storm. Rain's wiped out the trail.
Keep looking. Find them before they find us.
Little too late for that, buddy boy. Alright. Now, investigate the datapad. What's so significant about this datapad, I wonder? Yeah, honestly, I don't remember this chapter really well from this point on, so we'll just see where it goes from here.
I suppose a shuttle was too much to hope for.
I found something.
It's not enough to simply crash the shuttle. I want to see the bodies. No bodies, no bonus.
Chancellor Suresh, that Republic snake.
I should have known Suresh was behind this. I've heard rumors she was working with the Geno Haradon.
I had my suspicions. Suresh may no longer be Chancellor, but she maintains control over the Republic.
I really hate that woman. I make the dive. And then they lock us in. Or block us in, rather. Wonderful. We're stuck inside an ancient temple.
I'm sure there's another way out.
I'll blast my way out if it means escaping this bone pit.
You and I both, Commander. Shall we get moving?
Oh boy. Meanwhile, on Zakuul.
Reports from Droman Kaas claim the Outlander is dead.
No. Father's spirit is still rattling around in there. His little pet is alive.
The truth is irrelevant. The rumors have thrown the Alliance into disarray. Now is the perfect time to strike.
Odessen is too heavily defended. That doesn't change just because their precious Outlander is missing.
True.
Odessen is not the target.
Wait, what? Odessen is not the target. If I recall, there was a bonus mission in here last time that I could not figure out what to make of it.
tomb of another Sith Lord. I once thought these ancient temples held the secrets to immortality. I was wrong.
You seem to have found a way.
The body is just a shell, a vessel for the spirit. Emperor of the Sith was my first face, but it is merely one of many I have worn.
Clearly you weren't satisfied just being the Sith Emperor.
The Sith Empire was too corrupted for me to save, but Sakul was different. I saw potential in the primitive world, so I raised it to perfection.
I see plenty of flaws in Sakul.
The glory of the Eternal Empire has been tainted by my children. But it can be restored.
He's like the stinking devil's advocate.
When you take the throne, you will understand.
We still need to go deeper if we hope to find another passage to the surface.
Thank you, Empress Asina, Captain Obvious.
Baywan, now's not a good time.
This can't wait. Suresh just sent a message. She's heading here, to Odessen.
Seems she didn't wait for us to change our minds after all.
Send her packing the second she lands.
Some of the troops want to hear her out. They aren't sure the Alliance can last. There are rumors about the commander.
Remind them where their loyalties lie.
Stall Suresh. We're on our way.
Mr. Lawman warned us you might sneak off.
Little thing flapping in the background. Scan and use located relics. Okay, this is the quest I was thinking of. Last time, couldn't really find any. Scoping out all the booby traps first. I just want something like this one. Yeah. I just want something like that stupid thing right here on... Ew. Slimy guilds. Anyway, there's something on this, it's like this on Oricon, whenever you go to face the Treadmasters. And what the heck? Why is that like that? I got all these little glitches that pop up. Alright. There are relics all around this place. Right now, all I see are pressure-sensitive plates. To scan and use located relics. That was one bonus quest I never finished while I was scanning. So I think I'm gonna go. I'm just gonna go ahead and scan.
This reminds me of my earliest trials as an apprentice, clearing vermin from tombs on Korriban.
I remember those days too. It's like our lives have come full circle.
No matter how much we change, some things remain the same. An important lesson, I suppose.
I think any of these would be a relic you could scan. This bonus quest was always one that irritated me just because I didn't know where to scan. Oh well, we'll figure it out as we go, I guess. For some reason I thought you could scan the stones. Trying to figure out what in the heck we're supposed to be doing with these artifacts. There's a purpose to them, I know that. Talk about a death trap, goodness.
Thank you.
Decepticon. Interesting. Okay.
The ancient Sith Lords are revered on Dromund-Kaas. But to move forward, we must abandon the old ways.
Easy to say, harder to do.
I understand your skepticism, but I will prove myself to you in time.
Okay. Sorry guys, I've just been really trying to think about where and how to use these relics that we're supposed to be hunting and finding. That's not what I wanted. Oh, look. He's behind this after all.
Don't you know it's rude to make me come out in a storm like this? We should just seal the passage behind us, trapping you in here forever.
Not an option. Suresh wants the corpses. No bodies, no bonus.
So you traded groveling to Asena for groveling to Suresh. You're pathetic, Lawman.
It's Minister Lawman, and I don't answer to Suresh. We're partners.
You'll die the same as her.
You should have surrendered, Lawman.
It's not Lawman's call. The Genoharidan always finish the job.
Come right to you. Now finish them!
That's the last relic right there. I never noticed this. Oh my gosh, guys. Guys. Oh my gosh, guys, I'm so sorry for this long time gap. I'm gonna have to go back and edit this video. Actually, no, I'm not gonna bother. But anyway, so those are the four pieces. There's the stone relic tablet, there's the sword, there's the receptacle, and there's the blade rack. So, next time you go to do this, now you know. I just had to figure it out for myself. I was tempted to go online and, you know, try and Google what to do. Oh, yes. Da-da! Dark side is victorious! Alright, so put that in your receptacle. Wonder what's in that big relic right there. The blade and the blade rack. Check the room contents. Ooh. Whoa, 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 whoa. If the door's closed, I'm gonna be mad. I'm like really mad. And the doors are open. Alright, so you just gotta watch out. These flamethrowers. They can be lethal. We'll dip their flamethrowers, but still.
Stay back! I've taken your friends hostage. Anything happens to me and they're dead. This is Minister Lawman. Let me speak to the prisoners.
Oh, hello, Lawman.
This is who you sent to capture us? I'm a little offended.
You started the killing without me.
We can't let you have all the fun. It's good to hear your voice.
I knew you weren't dead. Never doubted it for a second.
Suresh tried to kill me. It's time to repay the favor.
Promise you'll let me watch? Suresh wants the Alliance Commander. She's on Odessen as we speak.
Hold tight. I'm on my way.
You are my guest. Would you like to execute the traitor, or should I?
I say we kill him together.
I fully agree.
Oh, that was a lot more satisfying than letting him live before with my Jedi Knight. Alright. Now to deal with freaking Suresh on Odessen. Blech. I believe, yes, this way is the minister's shuttle. Last time I played this chapter, I ended up just locking Suresh up. However, this time I think I'm gonna do the honors of killing her. Just because she's such a pain in the backside. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Sorry about the really long lull, but I've actually never figured out that bonus quest before. So being able to figure it out for the first time was actually pretty fun. I liked it a lot. Except for the part when the flamethrower was activated and burnt me and Asena to death. But other than that, it was fun. Now let's watch this entertaining little segment here. This is probably one of my favorite parts of Eternal Throne. Just because Suresh thinks the Alliance Commander is dead, and then bada bing, bada boom, he appears. You have to watch for yourself, though.
Members of the Alliance, as many of you have already heard, your commander is dead. There are dark times ahead. But fear not. I have come to offer you a beacon.
A beacon, huh? You lousy, no good, lying, dirty, rotten, cheating. And she tries to run.
I assume you know everything, then. I'll take that as a yes. It doesn't matter. The Alliance needs a leader like me. I saw an opportunity and I took it. I won't apologize for that.
We are well beyond apologies.
What do we do with her?
Execution, I expect. It's what Valen would do. It's what I would do.
And it's exactly what you deserve.
Is it wrong to say I enjoyed that?
Empress Asena is waiting for your call, Commander. We'll meet you in the war room.
Oh, man. It's so much more satisfying to be a dark side character than it is a Jedi Knight. Oh my gosh, you have so much more fun. Man.
Never believed you were really dead, Commander. Not even for a second. Can't con a con artist, right? By the way, if anyone contacts you asking about a life insurance policy that paid out in your name, just say you don't know me, okay?
I mean, come on, man. Really? I leave for...
Good to see you back in one piece, Commander. Don't know what the Alliance would do without you.
Where are you, Toria? Oh.
Seeing you standing here, alive and well, I can't believe I almost fell for Suresh's lies. Welcome home, Commander.
Does Dr. Augura have anything to say to me? Anyway. No, come on,
this
really?
This latest recruit, well, and... Brunmark is an unrepentant... Very well, I shall do...
Why do you always talk to me about that, Ogurab? In one of the quests in the past, I chose to recruit the Sith warrior companion, Brunmark. But that meant I had to kill a diplomat. No, Dr. Ogurab keeps asking me the same thing over and over again. I don't get it, but... Oh well.
Seeing you standing here, alive and well, I can't believe I almost fell for Suresh's lies. Welcome home, Commander.
You bet your backside. I'm back for good. Well, for the most part,
I apologize for everything on Droman Cuffs. But I still believe we should unite your people with mine.
You've proven yourself, Asena. I accept your offer.
That doesn't mean you're home free. We're watching you.
Enough! If this is going to work, we all need to trust each other.
Right. Sorry, Commander.
I hope to prove you can count on the Empire. I look forward to working with you.
And there we have it, folks. That was Chapter 2. Run through the shadows.
This is the cargo freighter, Radala. Does anybody copy?
And meanwhile, space is just blowing the freaking daylights out of the Eternal Fleet.
This is Carport 10 aboard the Gravestone. We got your back, Radala. You okay?
We've taken heavy damage. Need to make emergency repairs.
Roger that, Radala. We'll bring your freighter on board. Just hold tight.
Much appreciated, Koth. Looking forward to meeting you in person.
That's not a good sign at all. Alright, well, that was chapter 2 then, guys, so I'm gonna go ahead and cut it short here. And thanks for watching, alright? Talk to you later. See you later for another episode.